गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम कंटिन्यूइंग विद वन ऑफ द इंटरेस्टिंग चैप्टर विद पार्ट सेकेंड, दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 7, इंटीग्रेशन. सो फर्स्ट वी विल गो थ्रू विद द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ दिस चैप्टर नंबर 7, इंटीग्रेशन इन दिस वीडियो पार्ट फर्स्ट. सो व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ इंटीग्रेशन? बेसिकली एज यू सी हियर, इट इज इनवर्स प्रोसेस ऑफ डिफरेंशिएशन. Or we can say it is the process of finding the integral, or we can say it is the process of finding antiderivative. Earlier in my previous video related with chapter number 5, I told so many things related with the derivative. In this video, we will focus mainly on antiderivatives. So, what is the meaning of antiderivative? We will go with that. But in integration, basically we will deal with two types of integration, that is indefinite integration and definite integration. With the help of these two integration, we will solve so many problems which are in the field of science, engineering, commerce, probability or economics also. So these two integrals play a very vital role in that field or these fields. So first we will go with the word antiderivatives. What is the meaning of this concept and why we say it is an inverse process of differentiation? So first we will start with the word antiderivative, which is also known as primitive. So first we will go through with the word antiderivative, and this antiderivative word is also known as primitive, right? So if we take one function phi x as a antiderivative of function f x, then we can say phi dash x can be written as d by dx of fx. So here we will take one example. X square upon 2 is the antiderivative of x. It means we can say antiderivative of x function is x square upon 2. It means d by dx of x square upon 2, it can be written as 1 upon 2 into 2x. 1 upon 2 is the constant quantity and the differentiation of x square is 2x, so that it becomes x. If we write d by dx of x square upon 2 plus 1, now we will solve it. What we will get? Again 1 by 2. And the differentiation of x square is 2x and the differentiation of 1 is 0. So again we will get x. If we will carry forward it, it means you will continue with the d by dx of x square upon 2 plus 2. So what we will get? Again we will get the same value, which is equivalent to x, and so on. It means we can say d by dx of x square upon 2 plus c, when we will solve it, again we will get the same value because the differentiation of constant is 0 and we will get x. It means in all these steps we will get the same value. It means we can say infinite many antiderivative of a function x are available. It means we can say phi x is antiderivative of fx. It means we can say phi x is antiderivative of fx. It means phi x plus c is also antiderivative of fx, or it can be written as d by dx of phi x plus c, and when we will solve it, it can be written in this way. which is equivalent to phi dash x plus 0, because the differential constant is 0 and this is phi dash x, and where c is any constant. So this is the concept of antiderivative. After this concept of antiderivative, we will continue with one type of integration, that is indefinite integration. As I said, there are two types, indefinite and definite integration. So again, we are taking one function fx dx, or you can say again we are taking one function fx. So we can say all family members, yeah, all members of this function related with the antiderivatives is known as indefinite integration, and it is denoted by fx dx, where this symbol is related with the integration symbol. And how can we will recall integration of function x with respect to x, where x is variable of integration. Okay, so if we take one example, x square dx, this is indefinite integration, and it becomes x cube upon 3 plus c. Or we can say, if we will do the integration of x cube, it can be written as x 4 upon 4 plus c, where c is constant of integration and it is related with real number. So how can we will say x square integration is x cube upon 3 plus c, x cube integration is x 4 upon 4 plus c, it is related with some standard formula of integration? No, I will write some formula which are related with the standard formula of integration. So after the concept of antiderivative and indefinite integration, we will go through with some standard formula. These are related with integration. So there are some standard formulas. The first formula is, we can say integration of x raised to the power n dx, it becomes x raised to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1 plus c. We can say here n is not equals to minus 1, because if n equals to minus 1, it becomes infinity. That's why n is not equals to minus 1. After this, we will write integration of exponential function, it becomes e x plus c. These are some standard formulas. Okay, a raised to the power x dx, it can be written as a raised to the power x upon log base e a plus c. After this, integration of derivative function sin x, this is your minus cos x plus c. Then we will come to the next formula, number 5, cos x dx, this is your sin x plus c, where c is constant of integration, and all these are part of indefinite integration, right? So after these 5 formula, we will continue with the next formula, that is integration of tan x dx. So integration of tan x dx, this formula becomes log modulus sec x plus c. Okay, so there are so many standard formulas. After formula number 6, we will continue the next formula, formula number 7, and this time it is related with sec x tan x dx. So integration of this formula is equivalent to sec x plus c, where c is constant of integration. So whenever we will go with the indefinite integration, we will use one constant which is known as constant of integration. After this formula number 7, we will continue with the formula number 8, and this is equivalent to sec square x dx. sec square x dx, this is equivalent to 10x plus c. Then formula number 9, cosec square x dx, this is equals to minus cot x plus c. These are the standard formula. With the help of these formula, we will solve the questions which are related with indefinite integration. So after formula number 9, we will continue with the next one, that is cosec x cot x dx. Cosec x multiplied by cot x dx, it becomes minus cosec x plus c. Once you write the formula, go through with these formulas, because these formulas are very, very important during the calculation of indefinite integration. After 10th formula, we will continue with the next one, that is cot x dx, and this is equivalent to minus log, you can say it is minus log sin x plus c. It is log sin x, please correct it. Cot x dx, this is equivalent to log sin x, or if you want to write log modulus sin x, that is also possible. So with the help of these standard formula, we will solve the question which is related with the indefinite integration. Okay, so after these formulas, we will continue with some properties related with indefinite integration. So what are the properties? Some properties of indefinite integration. So under this heading, we will go through with this property. This is the sign of integration, fx plus minus gx, then bracket close dx. Then what, how can we will write it? It can be written as integration of fx dx plus minus integration of gx dx. It means if you are using plus sign, then in right hand side you will write plus sign, and if you are using minus sign in the left hand side, here also you will write minus sign. Second property is, if some constant is there, for example k is constant with the function, then how can it, can you can write it? First you will write constant quantity outside the integration sign, and it can be written in this way, right? So we will do always the integration of only variable. Constant quantity you will write outside the symbol of integration. So with the help of these properties of indefinite integration, we solve the problems which are related with the indefinite integration. So after these properties, now I am continue with some questions. With the help of standard formula, I will solve it. So I am continuing with a very simple question. How can we will solve the integration of you can say x plus 1 dx? This is the question, and this is based on indefinite integration. X is variable, 1 is constant, and plus symbol is given. So how can we will write? First we will write, let I equals to x plus 1 with integration sign. Whenever you write integration sign, it means you write dx also. Okay, now first we will go with the properties of indefinite integration. So first we will write integration of x, then integration of 1 into dx. It can be written as x dx plus dx. Okay, so as I told earlier, the standard formula of x raised to power n is x raised to power n plus 1 upon n plus 1 plus c. Right? And here n not equals to minus 1. So how can we will solve these two integration with the help of this formula? So as you see in this first part, the value of x is 1. And you compare with this formula, it means the value of n is 1. So you will put and here also, so that it can be written as 1 plus 1 upon 1 plus 1. Then we will write one constant c. Right? This is the integration of this first part. Now we will come to on second part. How can we will do the integration of this second part? So as you see here, integration of dx, it can also be written as x raised to the power 0 into dx, because x raised to the power 0 is also 1. So it means for this integration, the power of x is 0. It means the value of n is 0, and we will put n equals to 0 here, so that it can be written as x 0 plus 1 upon 0 plus 1 with one more constant. Let this constant is c1 this time. Okay. So it can be written as x square upon 2 plus x upon 1, it becomes x, and these two constant c plus c1 becomes a new constant, let c dash. So we can say here c dash is c plus c1. So either you write two constant or you write at last only single constant, both are correct. Okay, so this is the way of solving the question with the help of standard formula, and this is known as the integration of indefinite integration. This is, we can say this is the function x plus 1, and this is known as indefinite integration with the help of standard formula. And here we will apply, you can say, property of indefinite integration also. With the help of this, we will solve the question very easily. Now I am taking one more question related with indefinite integration, and how can we will apply a standard formula for solving that. My second question is, how can we will solve the integration of sine x plus x dx. Okay, so again, if you see, this is the sum of two functions, sine x and cos x. So again, we start with let I first, right? First we will apply the property of indefinite integration, so that it can be written as sine x plus x. We will separate it with the help of property of indefinite integration, and now we will apply directly the formula of standard formula of integration. So the integration of sine x is minus cos x, right? And the integration of x, as I told earlier, it can be written as x 1 plus 1 upon 1 plus 1, and we will write one constant, so that it becomes minus cos x plus x square upon 2 plus c. Here c is constant of integration. So this is the way of solving the question related with indefinite integration, in which we are using property of indefinite integration and we are using standard formula also, right? Now we will come to on exercise 7.1 related with your book. So I am taking one or two questions from this exercise. So first we will go through with question number 12, and the question is x square plus 3x plus 4. It is x square, no sorry, it is x cube, okay, x cube plus 3x plus 4 upon under root x dx. So how can we will solve the integration of such type of questions? So first again we will start with let I, it is related with exercise 7.1. I will mark it. Okay, so how can we will do the integration? So first we will write in this way, x cube upon under root x, separation 3x upon under root x plus 4 upon under root x into dx. Well, direct integration is not possible. as per the standard formula. So we have to rearrange it. We have to convert this complicated form in some simple form. Okay. Now we will solve it. So it is x cube and it is x raised to 1 by 2. So when we will solve it, it becomes 3 minus 1 by 2. As per the laws of exponents, as we know very well, x upon a upon x upon b, it can be written as x raised to the power a minus b. The same concept we will apply here, x 3 minus 1 by 2 plus 3 x raised to the power 1 minus 1 by 2 plus 4 x raised to the power minus 1 by 2 into dx. Okay. Again, we will convert in the simplest form. This is your 3 to the 6, 5 by 2 plus 3 x raised to the power half plus 4 x raised to the power minus 1 by 2 dx. Okay. So again, we will go through with the property of indefinite integration so that it can be written as x raised to the power 5 by 2 dx plus 3. We will take the constant, 3 is constant, so we will take outside the integration sign and it can be written as 1 by 2 dx plus 4 x raised to the power minus half dx. So for all the integration, we will apply only one formula, and this is the formula, this is the standard formula, x raised to the power n dx, which is equivalent to x n plus 1 upon n plus 1 plus constant. As I said earlier, we will use one constant at last, so there is no need to write again constant plus constant plus constant. We will use only one constant because the sum of two constants is again a constant. Okay, so how can we will do the integration of this? This is your question number 12 of exercise 7.1 related with standard formula and properties of indefinite integration, as I told earlier. So when you apply this formula here, it becomes x raised to the power 5 by 2 plus 1 upon 5 by 2 plus 1, then 3 x raised to the power half plus 1 upon half plus 1, and if you want to mention in the bracket, no problem, mention it. And here we will write x raised to the power minus half plus 1 upon minus half plus 1, or at last we will write one constant, which is known as constant of integration. Now we will solve it. It becomes x raised to the power 7 by 2 upon 7 by 2 plus 3 x raised to the power 3 by 2 upon 3 by 2 plus 4 x raised to the power half upon half plus constant. So when you will write constant, just after the integration you will mark it as a c. Okay, so after this we will again solve it and convert the answer in the simplest form. In a single question, we are using two or three concepts. So it can be written as 3 and 3 cancel one time. So it becomes 2 upon 7 x raised to the power 7 by 2 plus 2 into x raised to the power 3 by 2 plus 8 x raised to the power half plus c. So this is the answer of question number 12 from exercise 7.1. And this question we will solve with the help of properties of indefinite integration and standard formulas. Now after this question number 12, one interesting question I am taking, that is your question number 13. So again and again you will recall the formulas, write formulas again and again. All these formulas are standard formulas. If someone asks to you these formulas come from where, these formulas come from first principle of integration, that is also known as limit of sum, and that is related with your exercise 7.8. One concept is given in exercise 7.8, all the formulas come from that concept, which is known as limit of sum. So question number 13 I am taking, and this question is x cube minus x square plus x minus 1 upon x minus 1 dx. Again, direct integration of this question is not possible, So how can we will solve it? First we will start with let I. So as you see in these two terms, what is common? Here is x minus 1, okay. Here is also x minus 1. In these two terms, if we see x square is common, so remaining is x minus 1 plus x minus 1 is already given upon x minus 1 into dx. Now we have to focus on the numerator part. What is common? X minus 1 is common, so remaining is x square plus 1 upon x minus 1 dx. So x minus 1 cancel with x minus 1, and again we will go through with the concept of properties of indefinite integration, and it can be written as this. Okay, and when we will apply the formula related with x raised to the power n, it can be written as x raised to the power 2 plus 1 upon 2 plus 1, and here the integration of dx is x plus c, and when we will solve it, we will get x cube upon 3 plus x plus c. So this is the way of solving the question, because direct integration is not possible. So we will convert in some simplest form. We will rearrange it. After converting in the simplest form, we will apply properties of indefinite integration, and then we will apply standard formula, and we will get easily answer where c is what? C is constant of integration. So this is your question number 13 of exercise 7.1. After this, I am solving one very interesting question, and this is the last question of this exercise, question number 16. With the help of today's concept, we will solve so many questions which are related with indefinite integration. Now I am taking question number 16. Exercise is same. Exercise is 7.1. What is the question? Question is 2x minus 3 cos x plus ex. We have to do the integration of this concept. So how can we will do the integration? How can we will start the answer? So first we will write let I equals to integration sign 2x minus 3 cos x plus ex into dx. If we write integration sign, it means we have to write dx also, because the question is already given in the function. Question is already related with the variable x, where x is the variable of integration. So again, we will go through with the properties of indefinite integration, so that it can be written as 2x dx minus 3 cos x dx plus ex dx. Okay, again we will apply the property of indefinite integration. 2 is constant quantity, so that it can be written as 2 into integration sign x dx minus 3 into integration sign cos x dx plus ex dx, because always we will do the integration of only variable, not constant quantity, because the integration of constant is 0 plus c, that is constant. So when we will solve it as per the formula, so it becomes x 1 plus 1 upon 1 plus 1 minus 3. Integration of cos x is what? That is your sin x. And what is the integration of ex? This is your ex plus c, where c is constant of integration. After this, we will convert in the simplest form, so that it can be written as 2x square upon 2 minus 3 sin x plus ex plus c. 2 and 2 cancel. It means the value of this integration is x square minus 3 sin x plus ex plus c, where c is constant of integration. So I hope with the help of today's concept, that is antiderivative, properties of indefinite integration, or some standard formulas, you will solve the questions which are related with the indefinite integration. There are so many concepts which is related with the indefinite integration, which we will discuss in my next videos. Thank you very much.